Hi all, so welcome to this channel, and in this video session we'll discuss return statement in SQL stored procedure. So we have seen various videos uploaded by me where there is no such return statement in the SQL stored procedure. As we all know that we cannot return a value like we do in the SQL functions using the stored procedure. So basically we can have the input output parameters only in the parameter sections in itself. So basically there we can return some value in or out, or in out parameters, but there is another statement, return statement, which can be used there to return an integer value basically, which means if something some situation occurs, some error occurs to my stored procedure, I can return a minus one or zero or something like that to the caller. So which basically tells the caller that this stored procedure executed successfully or not. So this does not return means return doesn't mean that it returns any output value. It basically returns the whether it's actually executed successfully or not. Let's move towards the demo. So you can see this SQL stored procedure, stored 27. So you can have a different name for the stored procedure, but I kept this same. So here you can see the specific name and the stored procedure name is same, and the object would get created with this name of type PGM, and language SQL is optional here. So if I want, I can use it or I may comment it. Now here in the body section you can see I have several variables declared with some default values and some with not default values, that is are null values. So declare res, that is result is null, and these are defined as 1 and 0. Now you can see I have declared the exit handler, and which is for the condition divide by 0. So you can see this condition is also declared here. Declare this divide by 0 condition for SQL state error. So error is something which is customized SQL state for me. So I'm signaling and error which is customized for me, that divide by 0. I can also declare these two statements like this. Declare let's say exit handler or continue handler for SQL state this error. Now you can see when any error occurs, divide by 0 occurs, I'll return minus 1 to the caller. And if that's not the case, then I would divide numerator by denominator, and that would give me the result, and then I'll return 1. Means it the divide was successful, so I am returning 1. If it's divide by 0, I can return it minus 1 to the caller, which means the caller would get the idea that it's dividing by 0. Now you can see what I'm doing. I'm signaling this SQL state. I can directly write if I'm dividing by 0, I can directly write return minus 1 here as well, but I'm using the handler concept as well here, which is I'm signaling this SQL state error, and which means this one SQL state this. So I have defined this condition for that. So on this condition there was a exit handler, on this SQL state which I am signaling there was a condition declared, and on that condition I declared an exit handler, and that will basically return a minus 1. So it is basically, you can see I have commented the resignal thing and setting the message text, which is not required here because I am returning the minus 1. If I want, I can do that as well, but now let me tell you one more thing, that you won't be able to see that calling from here, that I'm calling this stored procedure stored 27 from some programming language like Java. So there are some ODBC or the JDBC interfaces from where we can call this stored procedure which returns something. So basically I can call like using the parameter markers. So let's say if I am, so I can use this equals to, then call this procedure name stored, let's say x procedure name, and then I can provide the input parameters if any. So there are no input parameters to this, so I can call it like this. But we can do this from the ODBC or JDBC interfaces, but not from the RPGLE. So I am directly going to call this from store 27. So you won't be seeing such things like we are getting the return actually, because we cannot call it from a RPGLE. So let's compile this. It's stored proc. Commitment control is set to star none. Just debug this. So you can see I have created the source with debug view star source. Now I'll debug this. Store 27, call the store 27. So here you can see denominator is 0, and this will basically signal this SQL state error. So once this SQL state error gets signaled, there is a condition defined on that, and on that condition there was a handler, exit handler, and that will basically return minus 1. So I am now exiting from the program and it will return me a minus 1. So if you call this from ODBC or JDBC interfaces, then it will give you that return value. You can receive that return value there. You cannot receive this return value from RPGD programs. You cannot make a call to such things where you are getting the returns. You can simply call this from the RPGLE, but there you won't get the return values, that either it is returning minus 1 or 1. Now let's say I'm calling it again. So let's change some values, like make it 4 and just change it to, let's say, 2. Now denominator is not 0. Now in this case it will go into else section, and you will see it will divide numerator and denominator, and you will get the result. So result is 2, and now it will return the 1 to the caller, which means the caller would get an idea that this executed successfully, divide was successful, and this way we can make use of this return statement, and we can get an idea whether the stored procedure was ran successfully or not. We can use the multiple or we can code the multiple return statement in a single stored procedure on various places after the declaration section, declaration of variable in the main body of the stored procedure, so that in multiple situations we will return multiple values or different values. So this way you can have an idea that how we'll be going to use the return statement in the SQL stored procedure. And for calling of this, you may have to use the, either you can call it from the command line or call it from this SQL, but you cannot call it. You can call it, but you cannot receive that return value into the stored into the RPGLE basically. So you have to use the ODBC or JDBC interfaces. So that's all in this video. Thank you and have a nice time.